To download the latest TeamViewer, use the following steps as your guidelines. Go to the official site to download TeamViewer for macOS. After that, select and double-click the TeamViewer.dmg file to start the download process. Next, follow the installation wizard to complete the installation process. Now we're going to set the TeamViewer settings. To do this, you have to access your TeamViewer settings from the main menu options. Go to Preferences and then choose Remote Control. Ensure that your quality is set to Optimize Quality. Uncheck Remove Remote Wallpaper. Make sure Show Your Partner's Cursor is selected. Now select the Advanced option from the toolbar and choose the Full Access option for both connections to this computer and to other computers. In order for TeamViewer to work, you must allow access to the computer system for access to the hard disk as well as screen recording. Firstly, enable screen sharing by going to System Preferences, then Sharing and check Screen Sharing. In the Accessibility tab, TeamViewer should be selected. To make the change, unlock the System Preferences by selecting the lock icon in the bottom left. You will be prompted to provide your system password to continue. If you don't see TeamViewer in the list of apps, click the plus icon to locate and add TeamViewer. You'll then be able to select TeamViewer. The next tab is Full Disk Access. Here, make the same as with the previous points. Make sure TeamViewer is selected to allow full disk access. Now I would like to show you how you can remote control your partner's desktop just in a few clicks. So, to set up the connection, you have to enter your partner's ID and click Connect. After that, enter the password provided on your partner's screen. The connection is established. Now you can control another desktop, open different applications, browsers or media galleries. I will be happy to answer any questions below in the comments. Write whether you are satisfied with the use of TeamViewer. Thank you for watching this video.